बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल, वेलकम बैक टू द एयरकूल चैनल। स्टूडेंट्स, ऑल ऑफ यू नो ड्यू टू करंट पेंडेमिक कंडीशंस लॉकडाउन इज देयर, दैट्स व्हाई यू आर एट होम। सो स्टूडेंट्स, टेक केयर ऑफ योर सेल्फ, स्टे होम एंड स्टे सेफ। स्टूडेंट्स, आई विल टीच यू मैथमेटिक्स ऑफ क्लास 5। Today we will start at chapter number 2, that is about HCF and LCM. Before starting the exercise 2A, I just want to discuss some divisibility rules. First divisibility rule of 4, a number is divisible by 4 if the number formed by the last two digits of the number is divisible by 4. Means if we have given a large number, then we have to check whether it is divisible by 4. We just consider last two digits of the number, then we check if it is divisible by 4, then it is a divisible by 4. If a number is divisible by divisibility rule of 6, if the number of number is divisible by 6, if it is an even number and on the sum of its digit is divisible by 3, means if we have to check if a number is divisible by 4, then first we check if it is an even number. If it is an even number, then we sum the digits of the number. If it is divisible by 3, then the whole complete number will be divisible by 6. Next divisibility rule of 8, a number is divisible by 8 if the number is formed by the last three digit is a multiple of 8. Means if we have a given a number and we have to check if whether it is a divisible by 8 or not, we just check the three digits of the last three digits of the number. If it is divisible by 8, if it is a multiple of 8, then the whole number is divisible by 8. And one more condition, if there are three zeros at the end, means 100, tens and one places, then it is also divisible by 8. If the digit is any number add up to the number which is exactly divisible by 9, then the original number is also divisible by 9. Divisibility rule of 9, if we means we students, if we want to check a number is divisible by 9, we just add the numbers of the digit. If it is divisible by 9, then the whole number will be divisible by 9. Now we will start chapter number 2, exercise 2A, filling the blanks. If the number is divisible by 2 or 3, then the number is question number 1, filling the blanks. If a number is divisible by 2 or 3, then the number is divisible by 6. Means students, we have already discussed, first we check the number that is even number. Even number is the number that is divisible by 2. If number divisible by 2 and 3, then it must be divisible by 6. We have already discussed. Next, B part, if the sum of the digits of the number can be divided by 9 with no remainder, then the number is divisible by 9. Means in sum of digits we have discussed right now, the sum of digits is divided by 9, then there is a no remainder and the number is divisible by 9. 103, it is a divisible by 2 or 3 or 6. Students, this is the even number and also divisible by 3, so it is also divisible by 6. A number is divisible by 8 if at its last three digits are divisible by 8 or zeros. 450 is divisible by 2, 3, 5, 9 and 10. Students, for these are the prime factors of 450. Question number 2, state whether the following are true or false. Part A, if every digit of a number is divisible by 4, then the number is divisible by 4. Means if every number divisible by 4, then it is a divisible by 4. It's a true. 9482 is a divisible by 9. True. 1920 is not divisible by 8. False. sum of 210 and 315 is not divisible by 6. These numbers are divisible by 8. True. Select the correct question number 3. Select the correct answers from the given options. 1 part A, 125 multiplied by 13 is a divisible by 5 and 13. This option is a correct option. All multiples of 6 are divisible by 2 and 3. We have already discussed. We have to write here 2 and 3. C part, all the numbers ending with 3 zeros are divisible by 8. Students, we have already discussed in the divisibility rule of 8, there should be 3 zeros at the end, so there will be 8 is the correct option. 444 is a divisible by 2, 3, 4 and 6. This is correct option. A number which is divisible by 6 must be an even number. We have discussed in the divisibility rule of 6, number should be even number. Question number 4. Which of the following numbers are divisible by 4? Students, we have to check using the rule of divisibility of 4. We check whether these numbers are divisible by 4 or not. So I have written here. First, students, I have discussed that number is a divisible by 4 if the last number of the digit is two digits of the number is divisible by 4. We check, we have given 1996. We just consider last two digits 90, that is 96. 96 is divided by 4, which is equal to 24. Hence, this number is divisible by 4. B part, 2000. If there are the last two digits of the number are zeros, then the number is divisible by 4. So this is a divisible by 4. 23606, last digit 06, that is not divisible by 4. So this number is not divisible by 4. Question number 5. Which of the following numbers are divisible by 6? Students, we have given numbers. We are check whether they are divisible by 4. We do step by step. Students, we have discussed that the number should be even number. We can see there is a last digit 2 that is divisible by 2. So it is an even number. So next condition kya hai? Students, we just sum the number of digits 8 plus 6 plus 2. Plus 2 plus 2, it is a 18. 18 is a divisible by 3. So this number is also divisible by 2 or 3. Next number is, the number is an even number. We when add them, 4 plus 7, 11, plus 1, 12, plus 8, 20. 20 is not divisible by 3. So this number is not divisible by 6. Question number 6, which of the following numbers are divisible by 3 and but not divisible by 6? Show your working answer. Students, I have done here. Students, when we check the number that is divisible by 6, we add the digits 4 plus 7 plus 7 is equals to 8. It is divisible by 3, but this number is not a even number. That's why this number is not divisible by 6. Next number, 8 plus 1, 0 plus 1 is equals to 9. This is 9, is a 9 is divisible by 3, so that 801 is a divisible by 3, but 801 is a not a even number, therefore it is not a divisible by 6. Question number 7. With the help of the rules of divisibility for 8, find out which one of the following are divisible by 8. Students, we have already discussed that we have to check the number that is divisible by 4. 8. We must take last three digits of the number. There is a 189, which is not divisible by 8. So therefore, this number is not divisible by 8. Next number 117000. Last students, we can see there are three zeros in the last, so this is divisible by 8. Students, next 6048. We just consider last three digits. 408 divided by 8 is equals to 51. So this number is exactly divisible by 8. 1493600. 600 divided by 8 is equals to 75. 600 is exactly divisible by 8. Therefore, this number is also divisible by 8. Question number 8. Check whether the help of the rule of divisibility, which one of the following are divisible by 9. Students, we know very well. We just add these digits. If the sum is divisible by 9, then this number will be divisible by 9. We can see here its sum is 19, which is not divisible by 9. Therefore, this number is not divisible by 9. B part 2457. 2 plus 4 plus 5 plus 7 is equals to 8. That is divisible by 9. Therefore, it is divisible by 9. 6083. We add the numbers. 683. Sorry, there will be 95283 number. We add them, there is a 25, sum 25, so which is divisible by 9, hence this number is also divisible by 9. Now my exercise is completed. Now we start new exercise, that is about LCM and HCF. HCF stands for highest common factor of two numbers, and LCM, least common multiple. Now we will start exercise 2B, filling the blank. HCF of 7 and 11 is a 1. Students, if there is a prime number, there is no common factor except 1. That's why HCF of a prime number is always 1. 7 and 11 are prime numbers, so their HCF is a 1. The LCM is always greater than HCF. HCF stands for highest common factor. D part, the LCM two prime number is a product of the number. Students, I have told you LCF of a prime number is a 1, but the LCM of two prime numbers is always product of the numbers. Kindly keep it in your mind, this information. E part, the LCM of 9 and 24 is 72. State the whether the following are the true or false. The prime A part, the prime factor of 125, 5 and 5. This is true. These are the prime factors of 125. B part, the product of HCF and LCM of any two number is equal to the product of those numbers. This is also true. The HCF of a 15 and 35 is a 35. This is false. The LCM of 17 and 19 is 17 multiplied by 19. It is a true. LCM stand for largest common multiple. No, this is false. Question number 3. Select the correct answers from the given option. The prime factor of 195 is 3, 5 and 13. This option is a correct option. When we make one prime factor of this number, these numbers are the prime factors of this 195. HCF of a 75 and 45 is a 15. LCM of a 3, 5 and 7 is a 105. These are prime numbers. I have told you the LCM of prime number is the product of the numbers. When we multiply with 3, multiply by 5, multiply by 7 is equals to 105. So this option is a 105 is a correct option. LCM of a 2 prime number is product of the numbers. I have told you right now. HCF of a 28, 49 and 70 is 7. Question number 4. Find the HCF by prime factorization method. Students, we have given three numbers and we have to find out the HCF by prime factorization method. I have question number 4. Find the HCF by prime factorization method. part A, 64, 148, 60. Students, first we find the prime factors of 64. 64 is a even number, so we will start dividing from 2. 2 divided by 64 is equals to 32. 2 divided by 32, 32 divided by 2 is equals to 16. 16 divided by 2 is equals to 8. 8 divided by 2 is equals to 4. 4 divided by 2 is equals to 2. 2 divided by 2 is equals to 1. These are prime factors of 64 we have written here in this form. Now we will find the prime factors of 148. 2 sevens are 14, 2 fours are 8, 2 threes are 6, 2 sevens are 14, 37 ones are 37. Next prime factor, we have to make prime factors of 60. 2 threes are 6 and 0 is as it is. 2 ones are 2 and 2 fives are 10. 3 fives are 15. These are prime factors of 60 and we have written here. Students, we have to find out HCF. We know very well HCF is the least, HCF is the highest common factor. So we will select common factors from them, from these prime factors. There are three prime factors. These are common and these twos are also common. So we will write in this form. The common factor are 2 and 2 HCF or 64 is equals to 2 multiplied by 2 is equals to 4. 4 is the HCF of these three numbers. Next part, 63, 108, 72. First we find the prime factors of 63. It is a odd number, so we will start dividing from 3. 3 twos are 6, 3 ones are 3. 3 sevens are 21, 7 ones are 7. These are prime factors of 63. We have written here 7 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 3. 108, it is an even number. We start dividing by 2. 2 fives are 10, 2 fours are 8, 2 twos are 4, and 2 sevens are 14. 3 nines are 27, 3 threes are 9, 3 ones are 3. These are prime factors of 108. We have written here 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 3 here, written here. Next number is 72. 2 is an even number. We start dividing by 2. 2 threes are 6, 2 sixes are 12, 2 ones are 3, and 2 eights are 16, 2 nines are 18. 3 threes are 9, 3 ones are 3. These are prime factors of 72. I have written here 2 multiply by 2, multiply by 2, multiply by 3, multiply by 3. Students, now we check which numbers are common in these three factors. Now, three prime factors of these numbers. There are three common. 2 times 3 are common in them. So we multiply them. 3 multiplied by 3 is equal to 9 is the HCF of 63, 108 and 72. The rest of the parts ones you can do yourself. Next question number 5. Find the HCF for the each group of the prime numbers, prime factors. Students, know we have factors. We have given the factors. We just find the HCF. We just write the prime factors in this form. 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 5. 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 5. 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 5. We just take the common factors. These 2s are common and these 2s are also common. These 5s are common. We write here 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 5 is equals to 20. So HCF of these prime factor is 20. B part, 2 multiplied by 3, multiplied by 3, multiplied by 5. We have written all these prime factors in this form. Now we take common factors and multiply them. Then we get HCF of these given prime factors. Rest of parts, friends, you can do yourself. Question number 6. Using division method to find the HCF of the following number. 39, 93 and 54. We have to find the HCF by division method. Division method is will be have shown, sorry, division method has shown in this question. Students, we first of all, we just take largest value from them, which is 96, and put inside the divisor sign and select remaining divisor from remaining two numbers. These remaining two numbers are 72 and 36. We are taking 72 as a divisor. 96 is our dividend. 72 ones are 72. 24 is a remainder. No, student, remainder is a less than a divisor. So this remainder will become divisor and this divisor will become dividend. So we will put this dividend in this sign, in this division sign. Again, we divide 24, threes are 24, 72. It is the complete, there is a zero remainder. So 24 is the HCF of these two numbers, 72 and 96. But we have to check, it is also divisor of 36. If it is a divisor of 36, then it will be the HCF of the given three numbers. Students, we can check that it is a 24, 12 twos are 24, sorry, if it is a 36, we write 36 here, 12 threes are 36, so it is also dividing, excuse me, sorry, students, I have mistake. I was just telling you that 36 divided by 24. First, we write 36 inside the divisor sign. 24 ones are 24, 12 is a remainder. Remainder is a less than divisor, so it will be divisor and this will become dividend. We put just 24 inside the dividend divisor sign. 12 is a divisor and 24 is a dividend. 12 twos are 24, it will completely divided. Zero is a remainder. So 24 is the HCF of this given number. D part. We have given the numbers 40, 52, and 76. We will select the largest number as a dividend and put inside the divisor sign. 76, and we select one number as a divisor. We consider 52 as a divisor. 52 ones are 52. 6 minus 2 is equals to 4. 7 minus 5 is equals to 2. This is a remainder. Remainder is a less than divisor, so it will become divisor, and this 52 will become dividend. We put inside the dividend sign. 52, 24, 2s are 48. 4 is a remainder. Remainder is a less than divisor. It will also become divisor, and 24 put inside the dividend sign. 4, 6 are 24. So it is divided completely. Now we will check whether 4 is dividing the third number that we have given here, 40. 4 tens are 40s. It is dividing completely. So 4 is a HCF of these are three given numbers. Question number 7. Find the LCM of the following using division method. We have given three numbers, 12, 26, 16, and 39. And we have to find out LCM of the given numbers. So we write these R terms in this form and start dividing from the smallest number, that is 2. 2 6 are 12, 2 13s are 26, 2 8s are 16, 39 is a not even number, so it will come as written, it will written as it is. Next, again we divide it by 2. 2 3s are 6, 13 is as it is, 2 4s are 8, 39 is also written as it is. No, there is all three numbers are odd numbers, so we'll start dividing from 3. 3 ones are 3, 13 is written as it is, 4 is written as it is, 13 threes are 39, 4, 1 is as it is, 13 as it is, 4 ones are 4, 13 as it is. Just 13 is left in this all numbers, so we'll divide by 13. 13 ones are 13, and 13 ones are 3, 3 is 1 are written as it is. Now we will multiply these numbers, 2 multiply by 2, multiply by 3, multiply by 4, multiply by 13. When we multiply them, we get 624, which is LCM of these given numbers, 12, 26, 16, and 39. Next part, 39, 81, 65 and 75. We do according to the rule that I have used in the previous question. We get the LCM of LCM by multiplying these numbers. 3 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 13. That is product of this number is this 26325. So it is LCM of these numbers. Students, rest of parts you can do yourself. Alhamdulillah, we have done our work. Thank you for watching. Allah Hafiz.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to Tariq Account Channel. Today I'm going to teach you grade 5 English. First of all, we are coming back to our work, which is poem workbook page number 5, Harm No Living Things. Read from book page number 21, Learn Meanings from Planning. All the meanings that has been written on the planning, you have to learn them. The theme of the poem is, now we have to learn what is the main crux, the main theme of the poem. The theme of the poem is not to destroy the nature and all living things. Plants, animals and insects have right to live in peace. The answer of the question number 1 is part A, insect, part B, fish and part C, birds. Answer number 2 is provide. Provide could mean specially given by nature, provided by creator of nature to be used wisely for the well-being of all creatures. Answer number 3, all animals, birds, insects and sea creatures should not be disturbed with our mischiefs. Plants, flowers, trees and greenery should not be harmed. Open workbook page number 6, write an acrostic poem. Hurt, all living thing, ruined material. Look at the things around you and classify them in the given columns. The living things we have seen around us, that is plants, insects, human, and non-living things are chair, table and buildings. Open page number 79, think and write. How can you demonstrate honesty as a trait in the following situation? You bought 3 candies, but the shopkeeper took money for 2. I will return him the extra candy. You find rupees 10 in the school ground or in the school can. I tried to find that person to return him his money. You get your performance sheet and your result is not good. I'll show my result card and will promise to work hard next time. A friend asks if he can look at your answers during the test. I will stop him to do so or hide my paper or test. Page number 80. Write about a member of your family. I love my mother. She is very kind and humble. She cooks meals, she sweeps the house, she washes and irons clothes. She helps us in taking shower and dress up neatly. She teaches us Quran, she loves to read books. I have learned honesty and truthfulness from her. I love to hear her childhood memories. Page number 81, you have to write an application for urgent piece of work. But be very sure about the punctuation marks and formation of your application. The principal, Dar-e-Arkam School, Lahore, respected madam, with due respect, it is stated that I have an urgent piece of work at home. Therefore, I can't come to school. Kindly grant me leave for one day. I shall be grateful to you. Yours obediently, XYZ, class 5, and your date. There is another application, which is write an application for brother's marriage ceremony. The principal, Dar-e-Arkam School, Lahore, respected madam. With due respect, It is stated that my elder brother is getting married. Therefore, I can't come to school from 7th Feb to 10th February. Kindly grant me leave for 3 days. I will be grateful to you. Yours obediently, XYZ. Now we have a comprehension, that is, complete the sentence giving your opinion about the situation described in the paragraph. We should help others in the time of need. Write a few words about several good behavior deeds that you do every day. I help my mother in setting dining table. I help my sister in her homework. Thank you so very much for coming.